gonna jump straight into it. And I'm rambling. Right. The first game that I'm going to show you is probably almost definitely the first football or soccer game that I ever played. I still love it, just because of nostalgic purposes and things like that, so I still enjoy playing it. It is international superstar soccer 64. Now, it was made by Konami. It's just amazing. When you first play it, if you were to play it now, considering the fact that we now have games like FIFA 15 and Pro Evo Seen back. massive, really, they felt massive. They were in a case of, there's one route, go down that one route. There were multiple routes down the mountain, which are very common in games such as SSX. Snowboarding games. They all Thumbs down, kind of, for its replayability. I know that one was brief, but I want to get through these, as many of these as possible. This next game has tons of replayability, in my opinion, and I wish EA would pull their finger out, stop making FIFA games, and make the new Skate. I wish somebody, even if EA does not do it, I wish somebody would take control and make a Skate 4. I didn't play the original Skate. Still play it today. Because I can't really skateboard myself. I did try for a couple of years, but then I just got into rollerblading and did that instead because I was better at it. But whenever I feel like going out skateboarding and realizing I can't actually skateboard, especially if be able to see what is new, but I have this strange feeling that it's going to play some old music, some 20s, 30s, 40s music, and show like a 10 second clip of something and then fade to black and show Fallout 4 on the screen. Decided to that it was time for me to get the DLC, so I'll be doing that when I have free time, because when I play games like this I kind of waste a lot of time playing it, and I probably wouldn't get videos done. I wouldn't be able to get to work because I'd be up all night playing it. So yeah, the DLC does look good, and this is one of my search every little box to see if there's something in there. Even if it's just a little bit of scrap, he'll get it to sell it. Even if he gets like 0.2 caps for it. But yeah, I sort of picked up that habit. But I didn't collect all the scrap because I was collecting pre-war books, which you get 100 caps in the library. So I'd take the pre-war books down to the library, get 100 caps for it. So I was like a collector. I killed it three times to make myself feel better about not killing it myself on my own world. But yeah, it's a great game. Definitely worth getting. But if you don't like grinding in a game, I apologise. And if you don't like really working hard in a game, it probably won't be for you. My advice is watch some Let's Plays of it and see what you think. Don't watch it from midway, watch it from the start. Watch a couple of videos of the start and things, because they will be grinding a lot. So yeah, I wouldn't waste the money on the game. Sound appealing to you, but it's a pretty badass game. So we have Oblivion. I think Oblivion is 10 times better than Skyrim. See its age a little bit. It's kind of an old game now, but that doesn't change the fact that it plays so well. The characters are so fun in it. The world is big, and there's so much to do. There's so many side quests, whereas the side quests in Skyrim didn't really appeal to me. There are side quests in this that remember long after you've played it, like trying to get into, I think it was a thieves guild or something like that, and you had to find something before the other three characters did, and that's a side quest that will stay with me forever because of how fun it was, and that is one of the reasons why I prefer Oblivion over Skyrim. This was before I would save all of the time, so I'd just play off with this autosave, and I was at this point maybe a level 80 or something. That was ridiculously high level. Might not be 80, might be a bit lower or something, but I played it to absolute death just to try and catch up with my friend who had been playing it for like 3 years prior to me getting it. Didn't bother me, I turned into a vampire, I thought it was pretty cool. You just couldn't stand in the sunlight for too long or you would die. Clever me though, decided to wait to pass the time until it was night, and I was stood out in the sun. So I waited 12 hours, and when I woke up, I was dead. And since I died, I had to reload it. The autosave, which auto-saved as I waited. So when I came back into the autosave, I was dead, which started again. So it was just a big loop of me dying, which rendered the save file useless. I learned from then on that I sort of have to save. I was also like a millionaire on the game because of the duplication glitch. So yeah, always remember to save your games. Don't trust the autosave, because it will mess with you. Yeah, just save your games, don't trust the autosave. sell it. It's one of my collector's copies now, so it's going to stay in my collection. I've played the HD remaster of The Wind Waker. It's really pretty, and it plays really well on the Wii U. But there's just something about it's like a little box with a handle, and it was a proper portable games console. Because of that handle, it just seemed on the focus. But yeah, you play as Toon Link, and you get a boat. I can't remember what the boat's called, but you get your boat and you travel backwards and forwards from these lands on your boat. Zelda's as well, and a 20 minute playable demo of Wind Waker, and I just played the Wind Waker all the time for 20 minutes at a time, just going around on this boat. I never progressed very far because I'd just spend all the time on the water, which wasn't a bad thing. They shouldn't have made the water play so fun. And now you get your treasure maps, and you can go find treasure. And there are things you have to avoid, and there are little like posts and watchtowers that you can go and see.